Thank you very much. Thanks for having me. Lovely talks so far, really inspiring. I pressed number two, right? Yeah. There you go. So yeah, thanks very much for having me. I suppose my talk is going to be a bit less serious and a bit wacky. So as being said, I'm the founder and creative director of Marlon, Tate. We're an ad agency with offices in Athens, London, Jupiter and Mars. Now, obviously, the last two offices are completely fictional, you know, made up. But I suppose we did that because it was some kind of an antidote and kind of poking fun into pompous big advertising agencies like the average European agency who they're operating out of God knows where. And they claim to have offices in New York and Los Angeles. And probably they have a rep there, but they still play as big shots in award shows and conferences, so they won't talk to you. But also, we kind of did that because we wanted to promote our narrative-driven branding and advertising and digital work for our clients. And we did quite a lot of interviews. We flirt with press and media. These are our last Christmas cards. So because we have offices in space, we created these Christmas cards. And they're space bags. We removed the air with a special machine that we bought from Amazon. And it was quite difficult. Our intern did that. and yeah, we embossed the logo. And by removing the air, the kind of thing shrunk. And inside this, we had a newspaper. And this is a completely fictional newspaper. And we wrote all the stories about non-existent planets. I wrote most of these stories while I was flying from London to Mykonos last summer. Probably, you know, you don't have lots of air on the plane, so hence the wackiness of the stories. But we kind of invented products, like fictional products. For instance, Moondies. It's a mood stabilizer for astronauts when they're flying from Earth to the Moon. And we wrote this story about Moondies. So Moondies are great for astronauts, but they do have some side effects because they can turn your hair electric blue. And there's also a rapper called Zane West. It's a complete fiction figure based on Kanye West, obviously. And we created an ad for his interplanetary tour. At the moment, we do other stuff as well. What are we doing? We're shooting a reality TV series showcasing our work, and this is the pilot.
Who the fuck is Marlon Tate? Well, Marlon Tate's an advertising agency with offices in Athens, London, Jupiter and Mars. No, we're not. Don't let us fool you. That's part of the narrative, part of the fictionalization of our brand, of our agency. But then again, you all know that. So,
so that's the pilot. So it was considered as a success. So we're moving forward with filming it with a better production, obviously. And you know, we're like really, really busy. We work crazy hours, but we're still having fun with it. And this is a job ad that we are posting, I think, tomorrow, next Friday, because we need a new midway designer. And this is the job ad we did for that.
You're all I ever wanted. You're all I ever needed. Yeah. So tell me what to do now. Cause I want you back.
So, yeah, again, we part of our job is to kind of interact with the press and the media, and sometimes this works and it's funny, and sometimes it's going horribly wrong. That's me on the cover, and gets really, really embarrassing. But our projects, they kind of cover the exist in the branding and advertising and digital sphere. I suppose the common element of all our work is the combination of strategy and fictional narratives. And it's the idea of a story that gets people excited and that effectively communicates messages and emotions and feelings and childhood dreams. Tonight I'm going to be talking about, that was the intro, by the way. So tonight I'm going to be talking about the power of storytelling and the idea of blurring the boundaries between graphics and fiction. So how it all started, like Marlon Taylor, like five people, and we have a dozen freelancers. But I started the agency a year and a half ago. So the idea of storytelling and kind of working and, you know, making fun of the brief or destroying the brief, if you will, sometimes, came back, I think it was 2018, and I was really tired. I was a senior art director in-house somewhere in London, and I was really tired with briefs getting cancelled or concerts getting cancelled. And I was kind of thinking of the idea, wouldn't it be really fun if if we work for a fictional client that doesn't exist? And then by thinking a few ideas, I kind of came up with the idea of, wouldn't it be amazing if we do a project that exists in a different timeline? Number one is, nothing is really impossible if you bend the rules of physics. What we did, what the project was, it's a trilogy of projects, and it's called Time Travel Branding. And this was the Xenia project. And the whole project, I did it at the time with a friend of mine, who's a famous fashion photographer, Polly Brown. She agreed to do it with me. So what we did was, we found these 60s hotel chain in Greece, which was called Xenia. And it was a really, really popular modernist hotel. I think there were like 68 hotels across the country. And obviously, we know what Greek summer is, so they were very successful. But obviously, mismanagement, crises, and a series of misfortunes led to this state of this hotel. So they're completely derelict and they don't exist anymore. So the idea was to go back in time and create the visual identity, the brand identity of these hotels as if it was actually commissioned. So it was a pretty kind of playful and conceptual project. And lots of times we questioned our sanity, but obviously it had to work in the context of the 60s. It couldn't be a very modern and contemporary thing. So we redesigned the logo, and then we designed props, leaflets, business cards that we had to find from some weird public service. We designed all these, and we flew back to Greece, and we photographed them in an existing hotel. And so, effectively, we created these image series of a past that never really happened. And so the idea was that, such a past has the opportunity to become a brilliant future. Fictitious, but brilliant. We redesigned cigarette packs from the 1960s, like top left there. Print ads juxtaposed to an article of the time, supposed article about Manson. And we did the menus for the hotel, vanity kits, and we designed a website where all the images were available. And then suddenly lots of people were interested about this project back then, and Vogue did an article about it, and then people started to kind of inquiring, how can we buy the images and all that, and we hadn't thought about that. So we made a book about it, which sold out. It was 100 copies only, but sold out. And yeah, that was really the first project that kind of connected with the idea that really you can do whatever you want as long as you bend the rules of physics. And so I should say that this project was partly inspired by Caruso St. John Architects, who I read an interview by them, and they said, we as architects spend an awful lot of time trying to convince clients do things that really they don't want to do. And so that was the whole point of it.